Good morning, students. Today we are starting another important topic of optics, that is total internal reflection. Basically, it is a phenomena of reflection of light. In order to understand it, let me take a surface separating denser medium to rarer medium. So here, in this phenomena, light travel from optical denser medium. This is a denser medium, that it is having refractive index mu 2. Let rarer medium having refractive index mu 1. So now, when ray of light is moving from denser to rarer medium, in that particular case, we will consider that the ray of light, when it is incident at an angle greater than some critical angle, then ray is totally reflected back into the same medium. So let we are taking a ray of light is traveling from denser medium to this rarer medium. It is incident on this interface. So now, as it is incident, what will happen? There will be refraction, and ray of light, instead of going along this straight line path, it will bend away from the normal. Following law of refraction, that ray of light, when it is incident at an angle, then it will move away from the normal. So when ray is incident on the surface, and this angle, when it is going on increasing, we are taking at this angle of incident, now it is increasing further, it will bend more away from the normal. For one particular angle of incident, that is that equal to critical angle. When angle of incident become equal to some critical angle is that particular angle at which when a ray of light is incident, in that case, ray will be refracted such that this angle of refraction is 90 degree. That means when angle of incident become equal to critical angle. Now I am just see here that ray of light is incident on any interface separating denser to rarer medium. Still its angle is going on increasing, angle of refraction also increasing. Here this angle is further increased, but for one particular angle, that is critical angle. What is that angle? Critical angle. Their angle of refraction become 90 degree. So now, after this, if further this ray of light is incident slightly or greater than this critical angle, if it is incident at an angle greater than this critical angle, then what will happen? Then this will reflect back into the same medium. It will be reflected back. Without any trace of the ray will be refracted. Then in that particular case, by following law of refraction, it will reflect back into the same medium following law of reflection. So now here, this is basically the concept of total internal reflection. See, you can see here, totally internally reflection, yani koi bhi ray ka koi bhi trace दूसरे मीडियम में नहीं जाएगा, इट विल बी टोटली रिफ्लेक्टिंग बैक. नाउ लेट वी रिकैप्चुलेट व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड, दैट व्हेन अ रे ऑफ लाइट ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम दिस ऑप्टिकल डेंसर मीडियम टू दिस ऑप्टिकल रेयर मीडियम इज इंसिडेंट एट एन एंगल ग्रेटर देन क्रिटिकल एंगल, देन द रे इज टोटली रिफ्लेक्टेड बैक इन टू द डेंसर मीडियम, इन टू द सेम मीडियम. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी हैव डिफाइंड दिस phenomena, totally internal reflection. Now, what is critical angle? Critical angle is an angle for which basically it is an angle of incident in the denser medium. This is important. We are not taking in the rarer medium. So, it is angle of incident in the denser medium such that at this particular angle, angle of refraction become 90 degree. So, now on this basis, here we have essential conditions. What we have discussed, let me will write in terms of essential conditions. अब देखिए, सबसे पहले total internal reflection के लिए सबसे important essential necessary condition क्या है? Light must travel from denser to rarer medium. Its reverse should not be there. Second, it must be incident on the surface at an angle greater than critical angle, so that at critical angle of refraction is 90 degree. So now if we will apply Snell's law, basically what information we get from this total internal reflection, from here we are able to get the refractive index of denser medium in terms of this critical angle, this incident angle. So now here if we will apply here this Snell's law, so according to it, refractive index of denser medium, let it be mu 2, upon refractive index of first medium, that is a rarer medium, it is equal to, what is it? It is equal to sine of angle of refraction to sine of angle of incident. You can just check in the diagram. See here, as angle of incident equal to angle of, this is critical angle for which angle of refraction is 90 degree. अब हम क्या ले रहे हैं? Mu 2 upon mu 1. तो angle कौन सा लेते हैं? Opposite medium का. तो angle इसमें है 90 degree. That is angle of refraction. तो next step में अब हम क्या करेंगे? We will substitute the value of angle of refraction and angle of incidence. So, refractive index of denser medium to rarer medium, on substituting the value of R, that is 90 degree, and angle of incident as critical angle, we are getting 1 upon sine IC. It means refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. And if first medium is air, then you can directly write it as like this. Either I am writing it or I am writing it, the basic relation is that if first medium is air, as refractive index of first medium is 1, that is air medium is 1, so I can replace this as mu, where mu will be the refractive index of that denser medium. So basically, image formed by this total internal reflection, these are brighter than those formed by mirror or lenses. Why? This is because in total internal reflection, there is no loss of intensity of light. Intensity of reflected light. That means 100% light is reflected back into the same medium. But whereas if you are taking mirror lenses in that particular case, there occurs some loss of intensity of light. So that's why image formed by this you can say phenomena of total internal reflection that are brighter. Now, let me understand this concept of total internal reflection by discussing its application. So, first application that I am taking, that is mirage effect. What is mirage? Mirage is an optical illusion. Illusion means just, you can say that is something appeared, but actually that event, that thing is not occurring. जैसे आप देख सकते हैं, अगर आपने कभी observe किया होगा कि hot summer day में अगर हम कहीं दूर हम road पर travel कर रहे हैं और बहुत hot day है, तो उस case में हम देखते हैं अगर सामने जो आपको आगे से जो vehicle नजर आ रहे हैं road पर घूमते हुए कोई car, तो उस case में क्या लगेगा कि उसकी reflection road पर नजर आ रही होगी. वो जो रिफ्लेक्शन होती है वो बेसिकली हमें इंडिकेशन देती है कि ग्राउंड पर या रोड पर बेसिकली वहाँ पर वाटर का पैच है, यानी वाटर है जिसकी वजह से उसकी इमेज हमें नजर आ रही है. लेकिन जब हम उस पॉइंट पर पहुँचते हैं तो स्टिल इट इज़ नॉट अकरिंग, और अगर हम आगे फर्दर देखते हैं फिर हमें वैसा ही इल्यूजन होता है. यानी इल्यूजन होता किस वजह से है? बेसिकली दिस इज अकरिंग इन हॉट समर डेज, और बेसिकली ये कहाँ होता है? डेजर्ट्स में. डेजर्ट्स में कई बार क्या होता है, इट इज गिविंग द इल्यूजन दैट समवेयर देयर इज अ पॉन्ड ऑफ वाटर बाय ऑब्जर्विंग द इमेज ऑफ अ ट्री और एनीथिंग एल्स, दैट इज गिविंग द इंडिकेशन कि ग्राउंड पे सैंड के ऊपर एक इमेज नजर आती है जो एक इल्यूजन देता है कि वहां पर वाटर है, बट एक्चुअली दैट इज नॉट अकरिंग. तो ये तो एक कॉन्सेप्ट हो गया जिसको हम मिराज इफेक्ट नाम दे रहे हैं. अब इसके पीछे टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन कैसे वर्क करता है? सी हियर, लेट मी ड्रॉ वन डायग्राम. आई एम टेकिंग अ सरफेस. नाउ हियर लेट आई एम ड्रॉइंग वन ट्री. ए any building, any tree which I am taking. And here, what I am taking here, I am representing different layers of air above the earth surface. Actually, we are not able to observe it, but these are we just representing to give you clarity that there are different layers of air having different optical density. So now what happened? As mirage is an optical illusion which occur usually in hot summer days or deserts, the object such as tree, this tree appears to be inverted. Here it will appear to be inverted as if tree is on the bank of pond of water. Now what happened? What is the actual cause of it? See, on a hot summer day, then temperature of air near the surface of earth, here it is maximum, is point pe temperature maximum hota hai, and the upper layer of air having decreasing temperature, yani yahan temperature decrease ho raha hai, yahan par minimum temperature as compared to earth surface. So now what will happen, that actually the optical density increases with height, यानी कि यहाँ पर temperature की वजह से ये medium हो जाता है rarer और ऊपर वाला medium जहाँ पर temperature कम होता है वो हो जाता है denser. तो कह सकते हैं हम कि optical density increases with height. जैसे जैसे हम height के साथ ऊपर जा रहे हैं, density of air, not exactly density, you can say refractive index of this air layer that will be going on increasing as optical density increases with the height. Such as, अब यहाँ पर होगा क्या? Actually, light from a tall tree passes through the medium whose refractive indexes decreases towards the ground. देखिए यहाँ हम कह रहे हैं denser medium है, हर layer का refractive index अलग अलग हो जाएगा. तो उस केस में it will have maximum refractive index and the lower will have minimum refractive index. That means lower layer will be rarer and upper layer will be denser. So now what will happen actually, see here, if I will say that the ray of light is going here, at each layer we will show it. Now, अब यहाँ से ये refraction होगा, तो exactly ये straight line नहीं जाके थोड़ा सा bent away हो जाएगा. It is bending away. अब इस second layer पर अगर हम देखें, further it will bend away. Further, if I am taking it, then it will again bend away. So like this, what is the impression that when we will, अब यहाँ पर एक particular, basically ये जो angle हम change कर रहे हैं, यानी यहाँ से हम देख रहे हैं कि जैसे जैसे angle of incident हमारा बढ़ गया, किसका, ray of light का angle of incident बढ़ गया, तो हम देख रहे हैं ये वाला angle of refraction भी change हो रहा है. अब particular किसी एक angle पर अगर हम कहते हैं कि मान लो ये ray of light मान लो क्रिटिकल एंगल पर इंसिडेंट करती है या क्रिटिकल एंगल से थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा पे इंसिडेंट करेगी, तो क्या होगा, इट विल बी टोटली इंटरनली रिफ्लेक्टेड. सो अब अगर हम इसको बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन में प्रोड्यूस करेंगे, तो यहाँ पर जो इसकी इमेज आएगी, यानी ये इस तरीके से इन्वर्टेड इमेज ट्री की नज़र आएगी. I am explaining it again, just listen it very carefully. Basically what happened, that the above layer is having higher refractive index, it is a denser medium. So now here ray of light moves from denser medium to this rarer medium, so ray of light will bend away from the normal. So in this way, when again ray of light is moving from denser to rarer medium, again denser to rarer medium, particular situation will reach where angle of incident become greater than critical angle at that particular case. So you can see at this point that this angle, it is not equal to, but it is greater than critical angle. So that's why this reflected ray of light is internally, totally, completely internally reflected. Now, when this is produced in the backward direction, it will give exactly the replica of the object. So you can see that this point was there, here we are getting the image. So we have just shown a single ray. So when the number of rays are meeting at the point, this is giving you the clear, complete image of the, that is tree. That is, it is giving the impression that there is a surface that is reflecting the tree. So basically here, what we are explaining here, that when the ray of light is incident at an angle greater than critical angle, then only total internal reflection occurs. So due to the same reason, sometimes during hot summer day, we observe a wet patch on the road while moving in a bus or a car. So this is the main point, and this is that's why it is an optical illusion, which is termed as mirage. I hope this is clear to you now. On this basis, let me discuss another application of total internal reflection, that is brilliance of diamond, that is sparkling effect of diamond. See, refractive index of this diamond is 2.4, and the critical angle for diamond through interface, that is air interface, is 24.4 degree. So now diamond is cut, basically the diamond which we are taking, so that is cut in such a way, its geometrical structure, it is cut in such a way that light once entering, it is not refracting, but it will suffer multiple reflection, and after suffering reflection, and it is incident at an angle greater than this critical angle. इसका मतलब इसको कट करते टाइम इस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट का ध्यान रखा जाता है कि जो भी रे ऑफ लाइट इस पर इंसिडेंट करती है, नो ट्रेस ऑफ इट विल मूव आउट, बट इट विल बी इंसिडेंट एट एन एंगल ग्रेटर देन क्रिटिकल एंगल एंड इट विल सफर मल्टीपल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन एंड हेंस इट रिमेन विद इन द डायमंड दैट इज गिविंग द इफेक्ट ऑफ स्पार्कलिंग. सो इन दिस वे डायमंड स्पार्कल एंड वी कैन ऑब्जर्व ब्रिलियंस ऑफ डायमंड. नेक्स्ट एप्लीकेशन वी आर टेकिंग totally reflecting prism. So basically totally reflecting prism, these prisms are designed to bend light by 90 degree or 180 degree. That is, they are shifting the image, they are rotating the image of the object by these particular angles. So here again, this is on the basis of total internal reflection. So here we are taking this right angle prism, and here we are taking a object AB. Now we will see that ray of light is incident normally on this interface. Now it is incident on this surface of the reflecting prism at an angle greater than critical angle, so that it will be totally internally reflected, and hence here it will move out from this point. So here see that from point B, whatever ray is entering, it is incident normally. So when it is incident normally, the refracted light will go straight. But for this point where it is striking, it is incident at an angle greater than critical angle, so that it will be internally reflected. Again incident normal, so it will be moving out. Let this point is B dash. Similarly, here point A of the object. That means here I have taken this bottom point, and this arrow indicates this is the top point. So here A point, from this when the ray of light is incident again normally, and then it is incident at this surface at an angle greater than critical angle. So now again it will be totally internally reflected, and hence this A point will appear as this. It means this ray of light, when this is coming back from this particular surface, now you can say that object AB is reflected by an angle of, this is rotated, not reflected, this image is rotated by an angle of 90 degree. So totally reflecting prism are used when the object image has to be rotated. So this is an arrangement where image has been rotated by 90 degree. You can just see there. So in exams, such diagrams can be asked to draw. Now the next case. Now this is a second arrangement, and in which we have placed this right angle prism in this manner. This angle is 90 degree. We have just rotated it. Now here, let we are placing this object AB like here. Now further ray of light will incident and will strike this surface at an angle greater than critical angle. From here it will be reflecting back. Further it will strike this surface again at an angle greater than critical angle, and then reflected light will move out. So let me see how. Here ray from point B, it is incident normally on the surface, then it is striking at an angle greater than critical angle, and then further it is reflecting back, totally reflecting back into the same medium. Then after this, this ray of light, it is moving out. This point is A dash, sorry, B dash. B is appearing as B dash, upside down. Similarly, we are taking this A point for corresponding to this A point. Again, I am taking a ray incident and at the surface. Again, incident at an angle greater than critical angle. This is a normal which I am drawing. Now again, from here, totally internally reflected. Again, incident on this surface, following the concept that it will be totally internally reflected. Why? Because at this point also the angle of incident is greater than critical angle, so it will be coming back like this. So A point will act as A dash. So I have shown only these two points, and in between, that is if the complete image you are going to obtain, so all the rays will follow such procedure, and hence you can see here that upside it down. So it means now here the object image is rotated by 180 degrees. So when the image has to be rotated to 180 degrees, then this kind of arrangement of the prism is used, and this kind of ray diagram you have to draw. An arrow must be drawn here. While optics, when you are dealing, hamesha arrows zarur lagane hain. What will be the arrow of incident direction and the arrow of reflected? So this is the second arrangement. Now here, after this, we are discussing third arrangement. In this third case, let the prism is placed in such a manner that this is right angle prism. Let the object is placed like this. Let this is A position and B, A and B point of the object. Now the ray of light is moving from this rarer to denser medium. So what will happen? That here it will not go straight, but it will bend towards the normal. So after bending, just let it may reach to point here, right? So now again, if it will be incident at an angle greater than critical angle, then this ray of light, because basically it is cut in such a way that it will be totally internally reflected, following law of reflection. Then again, this ray further, when you are observing it here, again it is moving from this denser medium to rarer medium. So again it will move out following the same law of refraction. So it will go along here. Similarly, this ray from point B, it will go straight, it will strike the surface, again bend towards the normal, and after bending towards the normal, let it be incident over this surface, this bottom surface, at an angle greater than critical angle. Further, it will be reflected completely, and again here the ray of light is coming back like this. So here you can see this point A, it is reaching here as A dash and B as B dash. It means upside down. Again, you can see here also, you can see that the object, when it is observed from this side, this is the image is rotated. So in this way, it is also turning upside down. So it is deviated, it is rotated through an angle of 180 degrees. So it depends upon the arrangement, how the right angle prism is placed, on which side the object lies. So this is very important topic, totally reflecting prism. What are these totally reflecting prism? How can we draw the diagram of the object for its rotation under different cases that we have discussed? So basically, if we recapitulate that, as totally reflecting prism are the prism whose critical angle is approximately 42 degrees, and when angle of incident is greater than 42, usually in maximum cases it will be given to be 45 degrees, and there can be three possible arrangement for deviating, or you can say to form the image. So first arrangement that I have shown to you, that is to deviate a ray through 90 degrees. Here you can see that this ray is deviated through 90 degrees. So here, after this, next point. So in this case, basically we are getting the image to invert an image with deviation of rays. Deviate kisse ho rahi hai? Rays are also deviated through 180 degrees. So here we are getting the image when rays are deviated through 180 degrees. Whereas in third case, so in this case, this is the case here to invert the image without deviation of rays. Here you can see that image is inverted, but rays are not deviated. So basically, the incident ray, which is on the top, emerges from the bottom of the prism. Such prism, these are known as erecting prism. These are known as erecting prism. Basically, these are used in binoculars and in projections. So this is all about your totally reflecting prism. Now, next application of total internal reflection that we are going to discuss, that is optical fibers. So what are these optical fibers? Basically, these days we find in the market that some decorative lamps are provided with fine plastic fibers. At their one end, fibers are fixed over an electric lamp, while the free ends form a fountain-like structure. So when the lamp is switched on, light travel from bottom of each fiber and appear at the top of fiber, that is at the tip of the free end of the fiber. So the plastic fiber in these lamps, these are taken as optical fiber. So here we will discuss how its working is based upon total internal reflection. Now this optical fiber consists of three parts: core, then cladding, and then buffer coating. So can we represent it? So this is the core part. Over it, here, this is cladding region, and over this, the outer covering area. This is buffer, that means this is core, center. Basically, what we have shown here, actually like this is a pipe, and iske andar, ये बफर कोटिंग है आउटर, इसके अंदर वाली लेयर क्लैडिंग और उसके बिल्कुल सेंटर वाली लेयर कोर. तो ये हमने इसका ब्रॉडन व्यू दिखाया है. दिस इज क्लैडिंग एंड दिस इज बफर, यानी जैकेट प्रोटेक्टिव लेयर होती है. दिस इज बफर कोटिंग, राइट? सो हियर दिस कोर, बेसिकली द सेंट्रल सिलेंड्रिकल कोर, इट इज मेड अप ऑफ हाई क्वालिटी ग्लास. और किससे बना होता है? या तो ग्लास या फिर सिलिका. एंड दिस इज हैविंग रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स एंड अ डायमीटर इज अबाउट 10 to 100 micrometer. सो इट इज हैविंग पर्टिकुलर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स वी विल टेक, एंड डायमीटर जो इसका अंदर वाला होता है दैट इज 10 to 100 micrometer. नाउ क्लैडिंग लेयर, the core is surrounded by a glass plastic jacket. This is a glass plastic jacket having refractive index mu 2. Basically this refractive index mu 2 is less than mu 1. yani central wale ka refractive index zyada hota hai, uske baad cladding ka refractive index kam hota hai. So in typical optical fiber, refractive index of core and cladding can be, this core having refractive index 1.52 and for this cladding having refractive index 1.48 respectively. So now above it, that is a buffer coating. So for protecting, or that means you can say for providing safety and strength to the core cladding interface of this optical fiber, it is enclosed in a plastic jacket. That means it is a topmost coating, topmost layer, so that to protect these two. So this is the construction part. I am just recapitulating that it consists of central core having greater refractive index as compared to cladding. This is made up of glass, but its refractive index is less than that of core, and this arrangement is protected. It is placed in between some plastic jacket like of structure, that means topmost coating. Now let me understand how it works. So previous was the detailed view of that optical fiber. Now from the front, just you can see it will like a pipe. Now what happened? Basically the central layer is core and the outer layer is cladding. We are explaining how total internal reflection help it. How it enables this total internal reflection enable the working of optical fiber. See what happened when the ray of light is incident on this surface, that is core cladding interface. So it is incident at an angle greater than critical angle. Core आपका denser medium है, cladding आपका rarer medium है. अब इस पे जो angle of incident होगा that will be greater than critical angle. यानी इनकी designing करते time इन points का ध्यान रखा जाता है. So when it will be totally reflecting back into the same medium. Further it will strike another surface, and that means on this layer, further it will be reflected back. and hence when it will be moving out, here we are getting the reflected intensity, that is it is moving out. That means what we can say, that when a signal in the form of light is directed at one end of fiber at suitable angle, it undergoes total internal reflection along the length of fiber. So it means, what are the essential condition for here, for its working? That it must be, light must be incident at an angle greater than critical angle, provided that core must have refractive index greater than cladding. Now finally the light comes out at the other end. So light, this light undergo total internal reflection at each stage. So this is a lengthy, this can be the complete length, so there can be multiple reflection. This I have just shown you the brief view that how internal reflection occurs. So when there is multiple internal reflections within this surface, there will be no loss of intensity of the signal. So these are so designed that the light reflected at one side strike the other end at an angle greater than this critical angle. So as this fiber is bent, light can travel along its length easily. It means when it is bent, it will not make any difference on the path of ray of light. So in brief, we can say that optical signals that can be transmitted through this arrangement, that is optical fiber. What does it consist of? Core, cladding. Outermost layer जो हम बात कर रहे हैं वो तो एक protecting layer, protective layer की तरह काम करता है. So basic phenomena क्या हो गया? Light is incident at an angle greater than critical angle, suffer, it is again striking to another interface, again suffering internal reflection, then again striking some other surface. So after multiple reflection throughout its length, it is having no loss of intensity and hence finally the signal will be coming out. Now what are its uses? As this optical fiber, it is used for transmitting and receiving this electrical signals by converting them into light signals. So whenever it is required to transmit and receiving this electrical signal, they are converted into light signals. Now a bundle of optical fiber, this is called a light pipe, and this pipe can transmit an image. So where it is used? It is used in medical and optical examinations. Of where it is used? In optical examination of internal organs like stomach, intestines, etc. These are also used in telephones and other transmitting cables. So these are all applications of this total internal reflection we have discussed in brief. So basic condition that will be remaining to the same in explaining different applications. Now revise these concepts carefully. In my next video we will discuss numericals on it. Thank you. Have a nice day.